Hello everyone, today we're talking about some stuff that is going on with the ATF and how it might be doubling in size. We have some more information as far as how it is actually going to get bigger, how the ATF is going to become more powerful when it comes to how they enforce laws that don't exist. This is something that we've seen time and time again, but this news is coming from our friend John Crump over at Ammo Land. He does a lot of investigative journalism when it comes to leaks and various behind the scenes dealings with the ATF, the Department of Justice, and the government in general when it comes to your Second Amendment rights. Now, I'm going to be reading from my phone a article that he sent to me prior to it going live. This is just some notes that I wanted to share with you when it comes to what is going on and how is the ATF becoming even more powerful. Hopefully, at the time of this video going live, I will have a link to the full article that you can read down below. Now, there's a whole lot of acronyms to keep track of here, so I'm going to do my best to try to be as clear as possible, and we might reiterate these acronyms and say it more than we might necessarily need to. So, effective October 31st, the ATF will be establishing four new branches. The branches will be the Firearms Enforcement Officer Development Branch and four Field Response Branches, FRBs. The newly announced additions will be part of the Firearms and Ammunition Technology Division and the Office of Enforcement Programs and Services, the EPS and FATD. Now, the FRBs, the Field Response Branches, will be broken up into three regions, East, Central, and West. Each FRB will be responsible for the administration, oversight, and management of the Firearms Evidence Officer Regional Response Program, the FEOs. These new field offices with regional FEOs, firearms evidence officers, are a departure from the current setup. Right now, all of those FEOs are currently in West Virginia. The new setup would have the FEO permanently assigned to regional offices across the country, meaning that instead of having one centralized location where all these experts are supposed to be, then if needed, they would travel to a destination, go there, check out what they need to check out, do their job, and then leave. This would now create several new offices where they would be permanently stationed, creating more people, more administrators, more cost. Now, for example, one of these FEOs actually looked at the rare breed trigger. This is something that's currently going on right now. The ATF is trying to say that the rare breed trigger, the FRT, is actually a machine gun in and of itself. One of these FEOs had to go out there and look at that. Now, the ATF is trying to create a system where there would be more of these FEOs stationed in more locations and doing more. Now, the ATF is trying to say that this is going to be a cost-cutting expenditure because they look at the travel costs of having their West Virginia-based FEOs having to go to a certain location and do these things. They're saying, hey, that's really expensive to do. Their solution to that is to create permanent offices that didn't exist previously, have administrators, have people training, create new systems, more people in more locations. So they want to spend tons of money to save a little bit of money. To me, that doesn't exactly make sense. The ATF is claiming that there's no downsides to this, that it's saving them money on travel expenses, but they're neglecting the fact that they're gonna have to increase the cost to simply exist outside of the travel expenses. So yeah, while your centrally located position in West Virginia created situations where people had to travel more and spend more money on travel, they are now replacing it with a system that requires you to spend massive amounts more money simply to exist. Yes, you go a little bit less distance traveling from a field office to somewhere nearby, but this is just another situation where they're adding more people, more power, and do I foresee this getting worse in the future? Well, with the push that the ATF is going, it all started with the bump stocks. Now it's pistol braces, now it's the triggers, now it's homemade firearms. They are looking to try to have more impact in more ways more often, and this is just the next step. We look at firearms that shoot really fast, and they said that the bump stock was a machine gun because it allowed you to shoot so quickly, even though it didn't break the actual legal characteristics of semi-auto versus full-auto. It didn't break the law, But the ATF said, yeah, well, we don't really like that anymore. That thing that you were doing that was super legal for a long time, we think that's illegal now. And setting it up like this is just their way of being able to do that in more ways. Because if they can get more FEOs to look at more items in more locations, they can infringe on your rights in more ways across the nation much more efficiently. If you truly believe that a government program has your self-interest in mind of reducing the cost, it just doesn't work like that. They are looking to spend more money and create more power for themselves and do more. What does the ATF do? Shoot dogs and kill innocent people. You guys know the drill. Have fun, be safe, stay dangerous. Peace.